So, Chef. Oh, that could be Nat. Oh, he does get Nat. I'm sure she does. Yes. All right. Good job to Shen. Cleans up that stuff pretty good.
Cablebox getting up smash. Looks like a close set so far. I don't know what game.
Matt's having a really good tournament. Matt beat C's like just now, and then now he's playing us. That was nuts, SDI. Matt, you're a legend!
He has his hat on backwards. He's like Ash, and he's about to catch a Pokemon. He probably turned it back right before the match, like, hey,
that's when he turns from Cablebox into Scorcho.
Right, yeah. So wait, is he still Cablebox, or did he change his tag?
No, he tried to change his tag on Big House 5, and we all made fun of him for it.
So he's Cablebox.
So he's Cablebox. But if you hear people call him Scorcho, it's because he tried and failed.
Okay. Yeah,
he's
covering everything really well.
He does
that's
that sometimes.
So smart. Yeah. I love that forward air because he reverse hitboxes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like forward air comes out faster.
Yeah.
It's, like more active, so he's able to just keep it out there. That's sweet.
It's easier, like considering the angle, like it's so if you go back air, you'd have to like drop down and back air and hit reverse hitboxes, but that you're gonna like four times.
Gotcha.
So like Matt, I'd say I'm like a little bit better than Matt, but he like just we play each other a lot, like him box. We play each other a lot. So like we go even, but he was like doing. He was kind of putting in more games today. Like
yeah,
the first few games, he's like playing great.
Yeah.
Which is funny because like he was like, I'm not gonna play both this tournament. I don't want to play this game.
That was me with Ice Fibers. I was like, I'm not gonna play AC today. Okay, that was really risky. But you have that up air off stage, you can get janked by Bob really easily, and that might be it. I'm surprised he didn't.
I'm surprised he got a shootout.
Yeah.
So one strong move.
Yeah, or a grab.
Stage, yeah.
If Gus gets a grab, that could be it.
Oh, Matt just
flashed
the approach, and that's it. Matt's actually so good at doing that. Like, a lot of times I'll get frustrated and then start running at him, and they just force me.
Yeah.
It makes me angry.
Especially because the angle it sends you at is like
abysmal.
So when you hold in, you like don't be on.
Yeah.
So it's like when you try and get that dash in.
That's gonna go to heavy.
Yeah, this is
I
really
good. Okay, so I agree, and I like, fully accept that first lead stage is really good. But like Matt like always beats me from this stage. I don't know. I think I suck on this stage because I was like called too.
Oh, he got slight behind the call. That's up tilt up air? Just up there. Oh, that was a smart back air.
It would have been better if it was strong, but yeah.
Yeah, because it would have sent him off. I think he went for stage positioning.
Yeah, it's nuts. I think Gus is.
That looked like Gus.
That looked like Gus, yeah.
Oh, that's bad. He's not playing really well in that like really close range. He's getting up smash a lot with like dash and up smash. I don't know if he's trying to like run a laggy move or something, but a lot of times when they're like right next to each other, he's just getting hit by the up smash.
Yeah. He has time to predict where he's coming from and everything, that's when he like can do well, but if Gus is like in his back, I'm not gonna go.
Yeah, that was a sweet grab. And yeah, just fall off and kick the wow. No, he's fine, he's got one more. Oh, Gus is dead. Wait, no one's dead. So we don't edge guard here. Yeah, that should be it. No, really good DI.
That was
so you can DI the back airs down, which a lot of boxes don't do. Because if you DI the first down air down, you get sent like below the ledge. A lot of times the puck like jumps up the back air
for
the combo. You can get out of it by just DIing it straight down.
I usually just SDI up and just make it as hard as possible.
Yeah, because a lot of times, like, if you get that first one up, they just know that it's just back air, and then by that point, you can't.
He's not gonna miss that one.
Come down, up tilt, up smash, up air, they'll all kill. That's up smash, easiest one. I always remember when I did that, I was playing Fox, so I didn't play, and I tried to run up smash, and I just ran up and then did nothing.
Yeah.
Because I didn't know you had to jump cancel in this game, because I only ever played Fox and PM, and I got rested again.
That's unfortunate.
It was really sad.
I, the whole time I was playing a set at AL, and I, it was game 3, final stock, and like, he missed, or no, like, he hit a res or missed a res or something, and I ran up to like, charge up smash, and I just like, just jammed.
That's awful.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. It's pretty upset.
Yeah, it would be too.
Thankfully I won, though.
Yeah. As long as you still won. I was hitting with a lot of weak nairs, but I feel like that's punishable. If Fox hits a weak nair on Puff at low percent, I feel like Puff hits a
like, it depends on, like, how they did it.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because a lot of times, Fox has enough time to be, like, shy.
Right. I am really surprised that didn't get punished. Wow. See, that's what I mean, that, like, really close range, he just jabs it, but that's not gonna work. And then you got up smash for it. Up there, back air, that'll be good. I did not see a handshake. I'm kind of. Yeah. I didn't know if he sat down or not. But they were on Battlefield, so I figured that was the game one. That would be the typical Puff counter pick. right?
Well, actually, well, it usually, sometimes it's best of five, but not definitely not the best of five.
Yeah, because he gets Dreamland and Mountain. And, yeah, and Dreamland, so in the mountains. I think this is definitely the better stage for Fox to let the pup go to. I think Dreamland's probably the only stage that this matchup might be, like, even.
I still think Fox wins.
Yeah, I still think Fox wins, but, like, I don't think it's as bad as any of the other stages.
Yeah.
Like,
I think it depends on the players.
That's actually really fair.
Because,
That was antsy. Knight died for it.
Ooh, he wanted to do a Tomahawk, I think, but, like, missing a few. So Chris always does those things. Like, that's the thing.
Yeah.
So, like, a lot of times you just, like, grab ledge and then do the fair ledge.
Yeah, yeah. Hit.
So, like, I think Matt can do that and, like, a very good chance of, like, closing out a lot of stocks quicker, which only, like, super important chance of doing that.
Right.
Last game specifically.
No, something in this Cablebox ceiling, he'll do, it's almost like Tomahawk, like, walks. He'll, like,
yeah,
run up and then just jump away.
He's really good. He really likes to, like, mess around with someone's, like, not mess around, but, like, you know, play around with someone with their chain.
Yeah.
Like, you're kind of observe what they do.
That might, oh, good. Gus was a little bit slow. Cablebox able to jump out.
Oh!
That was actually sick.
What was that F smash?
That was a
that
sick
was
ledge grab,
too.
That was
that
so good.
That whole section. I think he mixed up his DI with the F smash, too. Because
yeah,
he missed the tech, and it was like he could have Japanese up rats. So Gus may have just been like, you know, going for the smash DI up. Oh, yeah. That's yeah, barely. This stage is so good for Puff, because I feel like Puff has a lot of trouble catching the Fox, so the fact that it's small is actually not a bad thing.
Yeah, I agree. That's what I was going to say about Dreamland. It's like, Fox, yeah, Puff's going to live a little bit longer, but like, Fox still has so many ways to kill.
That's it.
Fox has so many ways to kill, and also Fox is pretty good. Like, that's how I beat the Foxes that I played it.
Yeah,
I just,
you
like, I just kind of ran away.
Yeah, and I think that's kind of where people don't, like, think about Dreamland, because this is kind of like, it's not the best of both worlds, but it gets you, like, some of each thing. It's small enough that you're not too claustrophobic.
Yeah, like, on this stage, you have to be super good at interrupting, like, reading your arrow movement, and, just, like, intercepting the airs and stuff like that, and, like when I play here, I just, like, try to do a bunch of back airs, like, walk them out.
Yeah.
And, like, I don't know. I think the better you are with normals, it makes you way better on the stage.
Yeah, that makes sense. That could be it if he... Yeah, that's it. That's game. So Cablebox is in. I think that's winner.